Hi everyone, it's Lindy. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing another What Sold video. Today I want to talk about sales from July 12th to July 18th, 2019. I want to talk about my sales and I also want to highlight some of the best items that sold for me this week. And the reason why I am doing this video is because I have the out of stock option turned on in my eBay store. So when an item sells, it just simply sells out of stock and the item is still active in my store. That means that you guys can't see any of my sold listings. So a video like this is beneficial for me to share some of the sale highlights that I have over the course of the week because you wouldn't be able to see them otherwise. So I'm going to take you over to my computer. We'll talk about this week's sales and I will show you some of the best items that sold this week. Head on over and check out the week of July 12th through July 18th, 2019. Let's go.
Alrighty, so obviously sales are down a little bit. They're actually right around normal. I think last week was a pretty above average week. So this week I did $1,264.96 in total sales. That is down 22.4% compared to last week. But still a pretty good sales week overall. So let's take a look at some of the items that sold. Okay, so the first item I wanted to show you is this Mary Kay Time Wise Age Fighting Moisturizer for combination to oily skin. Mary Kay, this is actually something that I bought from someone local that was just selling it on a Facebook marketplace. This kind of stuff I always love getting. Stuff that used to be MLM products. Sometimes you cannot sell those items, but a lot of the times you can. Mary Kay, you most definitely can sell on eBay and it sells quick. This sold overnight. I think I listed it and then I got an offer of $20, not the $21.05 that's here. I got an offer of $20 that I accepted and it was sold and shipped within 24 hours. So that was pretty awesome. So after fees, shipping, and cost of goods, my total profit on this item was $9.46. Next, we have some Vital Proteins Collagen Peptides Unflavored 20-ounce canister. This was something else that also sold very, very quickly. It did sell overnight. I listed it, and the next day it was shipped out and gone. So this I sold for $31.17 after fees, shipping, and cost of goods. My total profit on this item was $14.79. Okay, so next is a lot of 4 bottles of Smarty Pants Kids Probiotic Grape Flavored Gummies. So this one I sold for $21.05. My profit on this wasn't great. My profit was only $5.88, but I did at least want to talk about why I made the listing the way I did and why I was okay with this profit. So I had looked at comps. A lot of the times I never know what I'm going to price something or if I'm going to lot something up like this and do multiple bottles until I look at the competition. And what I was noticing from the competition was it wasn't really worth it to list bottles one at a time and sit around and wait for them to sell, especially because 2 of these 4 bottles were actually going to be expiring within the next 60 days. So you can absolutely sell things on eBay that have an expiration date, but you have to make sure that by the time the buyer receives the item, it is not past expiration date. And when items are so close to the expiration date, when I list them, I want to make sure that they are going to move and they're not going to sit around. Because after about 30 days, if these still have not sold, I'm going to have to be paying attention to my listings. I want things to move fast so that I don't have to watch the expiration dates. You know what I mean? So because two of the four bottles were expiring so quickly, I didn't want to just do single listings because there was too much competition on single listings. And I didn't want my listings to just sit around, and I didn't want the item to expire. So what I decided to do is I just lotted up all four of them together. I listed the individual expiration dates within the listing so people knew what the expiration dates were for every single bottle, and I priced them to sell, and they definitely did. This sold within 48 hours. It was a really super quick flip. Like I said, I only made a profit of about $5.88, but it turned really fast. I got the cash flow back, and I was able to move bottles well before the expiration date was reached. Next up is a 7-pack of the Pilot, is it Frixion? Friction Clicker Erasable Gel Pens. So I did not have just one pack sell. Actually, the same person had bought 3 packs. They took advantage of my buy two, get one free. I know that a lot of people might not want to do something as dramatic as buy two, get one free. They might just want to do like buy one, get one a certain percentage off, or buy two, get one a certain percentage off. But I've been experimenting with promotions a little bit lately, and I'm really enjoying the buy two, get one free, especially on the smaller items, because I feel like it's an opportunity to really utilize the shipping cost on small items, because stuff like this, you know, you can just add multiple items and it really doesn't increase the shipping at all, but it increases your profit per transaction. So that's what I'm really looking for. I'm looking for more profits per transaction rather than moving multiple transactions, if that makes sense. So especially with something like this, where I had, you can see here, I've sold 7 and I still have 6 available. So, you know, I had 13 total and I've sold 7 of 13. So when I have so many of one item, I really like the whole buy two, get one free thing because it's going to help move them faster. So after shipping fees, sold 3 for $18.18. After shipping fees, cost of goods, and all of that, my net profit on this sale was $8.31. So I wanted to talk about this item because it shocked me. It genuinely shocked me. So I had gotten this in a liquidation. It is Poise Impressa Incontinence Bladder Supports. There's only 10 in a box. I was thinking that these were going to be really comparable to like tampons. And so I wasn't expecting a single box to go for a lot. And all I had was a single box. I was hoping that I was going to have more because when one individual item doesn't go for a lot, if you can put a whole bunch of items together and, like I said, utilize the shipping cost and maximize your profits per transaction by having a multiple items per sale. That's what I try to go for. But a single pack of 10, I was thinking it was going to be like $5 and it wasn't going to be worth my time. That's why you always look at sold comps. So I looked at sold comps and come to find out one box of these was selling on eBay between $15 and $20 for a single box. I was absolutely shocked. And again, I say that is why looking up sold comps is so important. And you don't just assume and be like, oh, I'm comfortable with $7 on this. I am so glad that I looked. And I didn't just like set it aside and say to myself, oh, well, I'll just wait until I get more. And then when I get more, that's when I'll get around to listing it. I went ahead and checked the comps to make sure that one box wasn't worth more than I thought. And it turns out it was a big surprise. So this one box of 10 count Poise Impressa Incontinence Bladder Supports sold for $16.45. And after shipping fees and cost of goods, my profit on this sale turned out to be $9.68. Next up, we have nasal spray. Okay, so this listing, again, not everything is going to be a huge sale. And so I always want to show you guys that it's okay for things not to be huge sales. But what I want to show you with this listing is a couple things that I find significant. The first being, this is not a name brand item. This is Up and Up brand, which is the generic version of, or it's the generic version of something for Target, the Up and Up brand. You could see Flonase. Flonase is what it is comparable to. This is just to show that things don't have to be a name brand in order for it to sell. So this is an Up and Up brand 2-bottle pack. Each bottle has 120 metered sprays for the nasal spray, and it sold for $11.85. And you can see here, this is my next point. Not only does this sell, but it sells more than once. I had 3 of these, and all 3 sold within a couple of days of listing. I actually need to replenish stock on this. I think I got 4 more in my most recent liquidation pallet. So I actually need to pull those and replenish stock so that they can keep selling again. That's one of the things I love about replenishables in liquidation, is I could just grab them and just basically restock, and I'll have more available. The listing is already done. There's already sales history on the listing. It's one of my favorite things. So that was the third thing I wanted to point out about this listing. Not only is it an off brand, but it sells consistently and it's replenishable. And so every single time these bottles sold at the $11.85 sale price, I made a profit of $5.65 on every one that sold, and will continue to sell at that price. Next up, we have a bottle of Grow Girl. You Grow Girl. It is a hair growth supplement with biotin and B12. They're little gummies for hair health. It did not sell for $17.31. Again, this was something else I took a best offer on. I took a best offer of $15 with free shipping. I did have this item priced a little higher than some of the lower competition that I had on eBay. So when someone sent me a $15 offer, I accepted it because I knew I was priced just a hair high. And so, you know, I wanted to be fair to the buyer, and I took it. And after fees, shipping, and cost of goods, my total profit on this sale was right around $8.41. Okay, this was a good one. So this is a total of 4 bottles of Complete Multi-Purpose Eye Contact Solution. So it's 2 2-packs. They are large 24-ounce bottles. So 2 2-packs, a total of 4 bottles, sold for $35.77 with free priority shipping. Now, because of the size of the boxes and bottles, this did end up going in a regional A box. Luckily, the buyer was close enough to me. It was only at $8.40 to ship with a regional A box, so that was nice. So when all was said and done, my total profit after cost of goods, shipping, and all that good stuff on this was $20.51 for contact solution. This was another one of those sales that was very unexpected to me. I did not believe that contact solution was going to be worth selling online. I thought it was just going to be too heavy, that putting it in a priority envelope or a regional box was just going to not be cost effective and it wasn't worth it. I was wrong, and I'm glad I was wrong because it made me a $20 profit. Next up, we have an Intimina, is that how you say it? Intimina Lily Cup. It's a menstrual cup and it is collapsible and it comes with a little storage container. This is another thing. Don't overlook things like feminine care products. I've sold tampons. I've sold maxi pads. I've sold bladder supports, as we just saw. Well, now, hey, I'm selling menstrual cups. So these do have particular sizes. This one was a size B. I had five total. You could see here, I only have one left. That means four have sold. I actually sold all four within about a 2-day time frame, and then it's like the sales cut off, and now I have one left and nobody's bought it. But it sold for $14.61. It does go first class shipping, which is awesome. So every single time one of these sold at $14.61, my net profit was $7.97 per menstrual cup. So for four of them, that's a profit of right around $32 on one listing. I love replenishables and I love multiple quantity. So I really hope I get some more of these in stock soon, because that's a really decent profit per single item. Almost $8 an item. Next up, we have Schiff Glucosamine Plus MSM 1500 milligram tablets. Each bottle has 150, and I had one person, again, take advantage of this buy two get one free, and they purchased three bottles for $29.22. So these bottles, they were pretty sizable with a lot of pills in them. So three bottles did end up having to go priority. So after fees, shipping, cost of goods, the total profit on this sale was $14.47. Next up is a Godox X-Pro CETTL2. That sounds so high tech. I wouldn't even know how to say all that if I wasn't reading it. Anyway, it's a wireless LCD transmitter for a Canon camera. This was something that I purchased local and sold for $55.09. So I did give them free priority shipping. I went ahead and upgraded them. So after fees, shipping, and cost of goods, total profit was $35.82 on this. And I wanted to bring it up because anything that is electronics related or camera accessories sell really fast. This sold, I kid you not, within 30 minutes of being listed. Whopping 30 minutes. Now, I did price super competitive. There was other people that had these listed for right around $69, and I had started mine at $59 and then put it on sale just to try to get some sort of promoting with the algorithm. But it sold within 20 minutes, and I wanted to make sure that my price was a little bit more competitive than my competition. Number one, to move it fast, and number two, because this was actually open box and my competition that was pricing right around $69, it looked like it was brand new factory sealed stuff. So because mine was open box, I wanted it to be more competitive for that reason. So $35.82. Quick profit within 30 minutes of being listed. Next up, we have an old school vintage blast 2-stage pre-workout drink mix in flavor blueberry lemonade. 20 servings per container, sold for $35.77. After shipping, cost of goods, and fees, my net profit on this item was a whopping $20.97. And here is another supplement. So this was Lady Boss Lean Premium Protein Powder. It's a women's all-in-one nutritional shake in flavor vanilla cupcake. It did not sell for $63.48. I actually ended up taking a best offer of $55 on this. There was a lot of interest. It sold within a day. I'll just say that it did sell within a day. However, I was getting a trend of people sending me offers like $45, $50, $55. I thought that my price was pretty competitive with the market, but people kept sending me lower offers. And so I went ahead and took an offer of $55 just to go ahead and move it, because I was, you know, I was a little hesitant what the market was doing. And I know it was only listed for a day, but I mean, come on, when $55 is staring you in the face, you might as well just take the offer. So I did. So after shipping, fees, cost of goods, and all of that, my total profit on this Lady Boss Vanilla Cupcake Protein Powder was $35.74. All right, you guys, that's all that I have to show you today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like videos like this, please let me know by hitting the thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down below. Please do remember to subscribe if you're interested in seeing more content. And don't forget to check the video description. I will put some useful information in there for you guys. All right. Thank you so much again for watching. I really appreciate it. And I will see you guys with my next video. Bye-bye.